time.
4 years have passed since the death of Warchief Gorbach and Conrad Schultz. 4 years of pain, suffering, of fear and death amongst the Horde and the Alliance. The borders of Azeroth are no longer safe, and during these years, massive attacks have been launched on the Alliance capitals, led by Morbid of the Iron Edge clan. Of chaos, some keep fighting for peace, but all proposed treaties are denied by the nobles of Stormwind. As of this moment, the Horde and the Alliance are gathering their armies for a final battle. A battle that will destroy all hope of future peace between the two sides. In the meanwhile, Eden and Rory seek to prevent this war by revealing the truth behind the madness of the noble houses of Stormwind. However, the guild has been rejected from Stormwind as traitors, and the most valuable information is therefore unreachable so far.
Our scouts must have found something in Stratholm.
Ech, en je vreemde, Yimo. Seems as even the scaly could have seen them as we interact. For nothing but jerked. And the same thing goes for us all. No, it's called Charlemans.
This is hopeless. We've been searching for more than 3 years. And what have we found? Nothing. We might as well just let them go fight their wars so we can have our revenge on Ragnaros. Besides, there's no way we will be able to solve this mystery as long as we're unable to enter Stormwind.
We have to keep trying. I am certain that the cause of this upcoming war is some sort of corruption driving the nobles insane. Who knows? Maybe it's the same corruption that caused the Van Cleef incident in Westfall. If we simply ignore all this, then we ignore everything we stand for. The advantage of being a noble is taking uppercuts in the cause.
Sir, we were ordered to send all the information regarding Stormwind to you. It seems that the Alliance has recently won an important battle against a large army of Hordes in Searing Gorge, and in 3 days there will be a party in Stormwind to celebrate for this victory.
Thank you, Knighty. This might be a chance to meet with Thaner. He knows more about Schultz than anyone, and we could use his assistance.
Very well. We should send Ferdinand's group off to meet Thaner.
No, they will draw too much attention. Blazer and I will go alone. Time is running out and we can't risk missing this opportunity.
You're right. But be careful, Jim. I have a feeling that we're dealing with something larger than a new war.
But Jesus! I'm gonna get me some beers tonight. These Stormwind fellas, they sure know how to party.
Ha ha. Very funny, place. Another time, Thaner. I believe his dungeon is around here somewhere.
A dungeon? Hey man, this Thaner guy sure sounds a bit creepy to me. Yimo, where are you, man?
So I was just wondering if you would like to see me do some magic tricks for you.
Yimo, damn it, Yimo! Let's get going already, man.
Hurry.
Well, for his benefit, I'm sure hoping that he isn't paying too much for this place, you know what I mean?
It's not too bad, Blazer. It almost seems cozy down here.
Right, anyway, okay. Well, I think I'll just stay here, man. You know, me and Thaner, we're probably not going to have that much in common.
Honestly, Selina, of course Selina touched the succubus. It
It was me. Hmm? And now she blames me because I used my Voidwalker on my last trip to Desolace.
Yeah, so it was your imp? Right.
Yeah, exactly. Or well, not that way, of course. What was that? Yimo! Welcome, Yimo. I must say, I'm surprised that you were able to get here. Stormwind is like a fortress these days.
It sure is. It has been impossible for me to meet you here, but at the moment they are letting in people from the country. You see, there's a big party here. You really need to get out more, Thaner.
Well, it's good to have you back, Yimo. Now, I assume you need my help.
I do. As you probably know, Thaner, the nobles of Stormwind have been acting extremely aggressive these years, and we need to find out why. It is our only chance of bringing peace back to Azeroth.
I understand. In that case, I assume you're here for the diary of Conrad Schultz. Am I right?
Yeah, our scouts have told us that it is most likely located here in Stormwind.
It is, but to be honest, Yimo, I don't like this. This is not just an ordinary book. There is something about it. I have felt its presence for years now, but during these last months, the effect has increased dramatically. Something is happening.
Yeah, people keep telling me that. Anyway, we can't afford to waste this chance. Where did you say the book was?
In the northeast tower of Stormwind Keep, in the library. I wanted to go there myself, but getting past all those guards with a pissed off succubus is rather hard, as you can imagine.
I feel for you, Thaner. I'm sorry to leave you already, but time is short and we must hurry to the tower.
Wait, Yimo. I have a feeling that you will be needing some extra help, so kneel down. I'll buff you up.
Well, why not?
Rise, Yimo. You are ready.
Seriously, Thaner. I'm afraid your powers have gotten a bit rusty. I don't feel any different at all.
God damn it, Yimo. It takes some time for it to travel through your body. Anyway, I wish you luck, and may you return soon, my friend.
I will. Goodbye, Thaner.
Goodbye.
I don't care what you say, Yimo. That guy freaks me out big time.
Well, you can't really expect a guy with babies for breakfast to be all nice and social, can you?
Please tell me you're joking here.
I'm just kidding. He usually goes for a piece of bread with ham. Anyway, how do you suggest we get past the guards?
Oh man, don't you worry about that. That'll be a piece of cake. I'll meet you outside when I got the book. Oh wow, nice move, Yimo. Well done, man.
Hey, relax. I didn't really expect to be able to
you
teleport here.
You must be very bloody proud of yourself
just testing
now.
I guess Thaner's little buff did work after all.
Well, you better get moving so we can teleport out of here with the book, because those guards are going to come back soon. All right?
You two, you're hereby arrested for high treason against the Alliance.
Oh, bollocks. Lieutenant, how's yourself there, man? I'm afraid you've got a bit mixed up here. What are all these words, all these shenanigans you're coming off with? Hereby arrested and high treason and all that malarkey. We were just going to the local inn and got ourselves a little bit lost. And now what? What's all this about? No, really, officer. I mean, come on.
Very funny, Blazer. I've been searching for you and Yimo for the last 3 years, and out of all places, you turned up in Stormwind. How appropriate.
Well, life's full of surprises, Lieutenant. You never know what's going to happen.
I'm afraid you're up for one more surprise, Grimly. You see, we're leaving already. Goodbye.
What the bloody hell just happened?
I've got one question for you, Yimo. And if you wouldn't mind telling me, where in the hell is my hat?
Sorry, Blazer, but come on. It's my first double teleport. You should be happy you didn't lose your arm.
Well, I'm telling you right now that that's going to be the last teleport I do with you. Anyway, where are we now?
I have no idea. I did sure to focus on our camp in Tanaris, but it felt as if something forced us here. Some part of me I haven't felt before.
Okay, man, I know I'm asking too many questions right now, but what was that?
Oh, no. look.
Great, old some of Morbid's gang again.
Blazer, they don't look like Morbid's troops. Something's wrong here.
Yeah, that mage over there is blocking the entrance. I'll have to get him away. Which, you know, being a rogue and all, isn't really going to be a problem. Hi, Bonehead! You want to fight me?
No, wait.
It's no bother. You just let me take care of this. That hurt.
Blazer, this is serious. We got company.
Oh well, I can't see that mage anywhere around. Evidently, my fearsome appearance was enough to make him flee in terror. Oh well, look what we have here. Looks like one stayed around for a bit of fun.
I'm afraid they're a bit more tough than you think, Blazer. These are not the Forsaken that we usually meet. These are that are part of the Scourge, so be careful. Besides, I'm exhausted, so I'm not very good for fighting right now.
Oh, you poor thing. Is the teleporting been that hard on you?
Join my fight!
Oh, damn it! Here they come!
Time since I last fought any undead of the Scourge. But who are you guys?
Yeah, seriously, guys, do any of you know what the hell is going on?
Shyla, can you sense them?
Yes, they are in the tower.
Damn, okay, listen up, you two. We don't have much time, so you'll have to trust us. Hundreds of those undead are coming up to the tower right now, so if you want to live, then I suggest you to stay close to us. Get ready to jump.
Alright, you want me to jump down there, do you? Are you completely bloody mad?
They are here now, so if you prefer death, be my quest.
Swoog, eh? It has been a long time since I last saw anyone from the Ancient. But what were you guys doing at Carazon?
Well, we were going to ask you the same question, Jimo. In the last couple of weeks, the Scourge has set up camps in the area, apparently preparing for something big. Even though they seem to be of no harm to us, we chose to set out our patrols in the area to keep an eye on their activity. But strangely enough, their only activity has been the attack on you and Blazer. Do you have any idea why?
I'm afraid not. Blazer and I accidentally teleported to the place after retrieving this book, which is the diary of Conrad Schultz. I have been able to have a glimpse at the content, but everything seems to be written in a foreign language of some kind.
Let me have a look at it. Strange. This is written in some sort of ancient demonic tongue. This is a Falch book, no doubt. I wonder how a book like this could end up in Stormwind.
Are you able to translate any of it, Yubai?
I'm afraid not. This is way beyond me.
What is it?
Well, it's a long shot, but there is one tower that might be able to translate some of this. But he resides far from here, in the distant lands of Fearless. It's a long and dangerous journey, and I'm not sure it would be a good idea to try and find him.
We have no choice, Yubai. You know just as well as I that a final war is coming. We have to take the chance.
He's right, Yubai. I went with Swarm to Senegon not long ago. I saw the battle. We're running out of time. Yimo, I will let Paul and Exconsua travel with you. I wish I could aid you with more warriors, but the constant battles force us to stick together.
I understand. We will be more than happy for the companionship of these big Tauren. One thing though, what is the name of this Tauren we are to meet?
War. Now let me tell you something before you go.
This is it. What you see before are the twin colossals. This is where Quar resides, Jemo. I believe Chubai told you what to do from here.
Yeah, I must go alone, so just wait for me here. I will be back soon, I hope. Okay, let's see. Point and jump.
Jemo, you have been expecting.
Well, I'm just glad Yubai told me how to get up here, because it would have been a hell of a climb. Anyway, Guar, I have come to ask for your help with a certain book I have brought with me.
The so-called Diary of Conrad Schultz?
That's the one.
Let me have a look at it. It has been long since I last read this cursed language, but one thing is certain. This has not been written by Conrad Schultz. I am able to understand the language, but this book is written in some sort of mysterious code that I have never seen before.
Do you have any idea of the purpose of this book then?
It has to do with some sort of ritual, perhaps a summoning of some kind. It mentions the Dark Whisper Gorge several places.
Where is that?
In the southern part of Windspring, far away from here. But the place is cursed. It's not the place anymore, Shugo.
We have no choice. The whole dark ritual thing smells far away of the corruption we've been seeking. If we're able to prove some sort of connection and perhaps even stop the corruption, then we may be able to end the war as well.
I see. Stubborn little creatures you know, Zorn. However, even I cannot tell what you may find in Dark Whisper Gorge. And they may very well be beyond your understanding. Therefore, I'll ask you to bring what you see to me.
So, you want me to bring my sights to you? Now, would that be possible?
Not only your sights, Shimo. Your every form as well. Here, take this sword.
What is this? Some sort of artifact?
It is an orb of wishing, and rather rare these days. By the touch of a mortal being, the orb will be bound to the soul of this being. And it will act as an imitation of the mind. Every single impression and thought will be gathered inside the orb as well as in the mind. Upon your return, I will be able to study everything you've seen through the orb.
So what happens if I accidentally destroy it? It seems rather fragile.
Don't worry about that. It can only be destroyed by the flames and tremors. But in case it is destroyed,
Your impressions, your experience, and your thoughts will be shared by everyone within miles.
Okay, well, I don't know if that will happen, because, you see, there is this girl. Never mind. I better get going. Thanks for your help, War. I hope we'll meet again. I have many things I would like to discuss with you.
Indeed. I shall look forward to your return, Jima. May the Earth Mother guide you.
Farewell.
Farewell.
Okay, so let me get this straight here. We're going to travel to some really creepy and ultra dangerous place, even though the wisest druid in the entire world has told us that it would be a bad idea. Am I the only person that feels an important point is being missed here?
The weak fear danger, but the strong seek it.
Yeah, right. Dead on. Anyway, since, you know, we're planning on going on this suicide mission tomorrow, maybe we should set up camp for the night.
My sword is my pillow. You shall try.
Yes, it is. It is known that sword pillows are lovely and very, very comfortable and safe as well. Good for the posture. Anyway, let's put up a camp here tonight, fellas.
We will patrol the area and keep eye for any activity. Sleep well, little ones.
I'm having this strange feeling, Blazer. I feel empty. I have a feeling that something is very wrong.
Yeah, I know. I have the same feeling. You know, it just seems strange that all of this has happened by coincidence. From the moment that we stepped into Stormwind, it felt as if we've been guided, you know, in some way. But then again, I might just be tired.
It's strange, though, this life. Everywhere around us, wars are fought, and neither side seems to know the reason. And when innocents are dying, we do nothing but claim our revenge. I hope we'll be able to counter this, Blazer. That is my wish. But I better get some sleep. Good night, friend.
Good night, Yimo.
Yimo. The chosen one. The bringer of death among the dead.
What? What do you mean? Is this a dream? And who are you?
Oh, we believe you know our name very well, little one.
You. You're him, aren't you? Arthas. How can you be here? This is my dream. My mind.
Yimo. It seems like we're talking past each other. I'm simply here to thank you for your extraordinary help.
Help? What are you talking about? I would never help you.
I'll explain it to you. It's quite ironic, you see. The book, which you had retrieved from Stormwind, is in fact not just a mere book. I know your memories, Yimo. I know what Quar told you. But what none of you realize is the true content of this book. Within it lies a power which no army or strength can give you. It's a power beyond your comprehension, so I won't even bother explaining it.
But why would you need more power? You're already able to destroy the entire world if you wanted to.
But what would I achieve by doing so? Anyhow, these days you just can't get any ancient dark artifact for free. And to gain the power of this book, you must fuse it with the missing piece. Purity. You see, Yimo, that book works in a rather similar way to your opposition. When touched by the right person, the book will drain the very soul of his being. So I'll ask you, haven't you felt slightly empty lately, Yimo?
But why me?
Here comes the irony. You are dedicated, Yimo. For years you have been doing nothing but trying to prevent others from meeting their death in war. Even though you have meant nothing but hate, you would still sacrifice your life. life for them. And yes, you would even sacrifice your own soul. That is why you're so rare, Yimo. Your love and compassion reaches beyond that of mortals. It's funny, isn't it? You've spent so much time trying to prevent this war, which would have caused death and destruction among all the races of this world. But the only thing you've achieved is to ensure that they will meet a far worse destiny than death.
So you're behind the corruption of Stormwind's nobles. You're the cause of this meaningless war.
I'm leaving the one to thank for this. Don't you see, Yimo? There was never any corruption at all. Evil is in every soul, even in those that you wish to save. Though I must admit that it's been rather fun to watch them fight each other. I have been shaping your doom in peace.
Let me ask you something. Why didn't you just capture me when I touched the boat? Why let me go through all this?
Yimo, I don't have all the time in the world. You see, draining your soul is rather a slow process. Until you are forced to focus on something outside your body. That is why I rigged this little adventure for you. Vader never really gave you the ability to teleport. He was in control all the time. It's amazing what warlocks would do if you give them a little power. But you can imagine how fast your soul was drained during your little fight with the patrol at Karasan. Soon, the book will be whole.
Besides, I'm exhausted. Then let me ask you something else. Why in the world are you telling me all this?
Oh well, I was afraid you'd never ask. You see, at this very moment, patrols are tracing the book, which you carry. And soon I will have both you and the book within my reach. And by the way, I'll make sure to have fun with torturing your dear friends to death.
No.
Yimo, you off for some breakfast, man? Yimo? Paul, where's Yimo?
I have no idea. I suddenly fell asleep and I just wake up.
Oh no, they must have taken him.
I can smell him. He's that way.
Oh no, that's the way to Dark Whispering Gods. Nobody should go Terra alone.
Right, well, let's go then, come on, we can't waste any time!
So be it, Lich King. I will sacrifice my life and my soul so that you will never gain the book's power. I'm just sad that I will never see you again, dear friends. Not even in heaven. The last thing I should see is the bottom of this valley. What's that sound?
Wait, there's an undead patrol behind him!
Yimo, watch out behind you!
Blazer, help Yimo!
But what about you?
Go, now!
Yeah!
Blazer.
Yimo, we have to get out of here! Use the teleport now!
No, Blazer. I mustn't live.
What are you talking about?
It will all be explained. Here, the book and the orb are in your backpack. I'll get you out of here. Please stop them, Blazer. Please stop him.
No, Yimo, don't!
May you live well, my friend.
No, wait, Yimo! No!
Goodbye.
No!
After this battle, there will be nothing but war. Death. If only both sides could realize how meaningless this war is. I just wish there was
some... Don't start, Minori. We've already discussed this.
The Serventus. All these innocent people will die. Don't you even care?
Oh, I care. I care just as much when the orcs slaughtered my family. You know nothing of pain, Minori. This is pain. Now... leave me alone. Today! We're not only here to defend the mighty capital of Ironforge. We're not only here to show the world what the Alliance is made of. No! Today we shall claim our revenge for those that have fallen. And I tell you, do not fear death, for your name shall live in eternity. So I ask you, will you follow me into legend? Then follow me!
Slaves to the false treaty of the Alliance. For too long have I played Stursy for revenge. I have held the innocent children dying in my arms. and I shall accept it no more! No! Today will be the day when we end this insolence and bring justice back to the Horde.
Yimo, you will always be in our hearts, as a friend, as an ideal. None of us will forget what you have done, what no one else would do. And I will not let your soul be lost. I'll get it back, you hear me? I'll get it back. I'm gonna do whatever it takes. Whatever it takes. And so at last, the fight between the Horde and the Alliance has been put to an end. At least for now. Thanks to Yimo and his sacrifice, we are able to stand united once again. Just as he would have wished. Just as he would have wished. Sometimes, though, you have to wonder. Why is a new, more deadly foe needed for us to stop our meaningless killing of each other? Why must I watch my friends die in battle? And why must their loved ones suffer for what is essentially nothing more than a stupid war of men? I don't have that answer. Eden Aurora has been reaccepted as part of the Alliance, and we have been given the task of finding a way to defeat Arthas. And we are now forced to face the Lich King and the Scourge, together, whatever comes. And that fight may very well be our last, our final tale. And so that is what we now know, Gwar. But how do you suggest we kill someone who's invincible?
I think you may be exaggerating, Blazer. Let me ask you a question.
And what question is that, Gwar?
Have you ever heard of the Ashbringer?
God, you killed her!
She must be joking.
tell me.